Hello lovely people, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, hi, my name is Indu. I make videos on makeup, skincare, haircare and lifestyle. And for today's video, I'm finally doing the one dip makeup challenge. If you don't know what this challenge is like, it's basically you just only get one dip or one chance to use a product. I mean, for example, if I'm using this bronzer, I only get one chance to dip my brush into it and that's it. I'll just have to do with whatever I get in one go. So that's basically the challenge, and I would say it's pretty self-explanatory. It's just one dip makeup challenge. So yeah, to be honest, I'm not really that excited, but anyways, let's just get started with the video. Alright, so let's just begin. I'm gonna start off by priming my face, and for that I'll be using this Color Bar primer. I'll leave all the product details in the description box, so please don't forget to check it out, because I don't think I will be able to show you all the products throughout this video just because I'll be very busy matching my one side to the other. You know what, I'm gonna be a little bit strategic because this primer comes in a spray form, so I'll not spray it all over my face because we usually overdo with our sprays and I only get one chance of it, so I'm not gonna waste it spraying my face because I know I will be left with spraying it in just one part of my face. So what I'm gonna do is I'll spray it on my hand, I'll just rub it and pat it all over my face. I hope that works. Let's just see if I'm smart enough or not. Alright, so there you go. I'm just gonna spray it on my hand for once. So my face has been primed really bad. Anyways, let's just move on to the foundation. I'm quickly just gonna put it back. And for foundation, I'll be using Maybelline 24 Hour Super Stay Foundation. I'm gonna give it a good shake. So I'm just gonna pump it. Let's just pump it out. All right. I need this baby right there. I think that's enough foundation. I don't usually use a lot of foundation on my face, but the thing is, I tend to build up my coverage. I mean, I take at least twice, so I think I'm gonna save a little bit for later. And just, and also what I'm gonna do is I'll firstly dot it all over my face and then just blend it out a little bit with my fingers, because sponges usually tend to soak up most of the product and you are left with a little bit less coverage that I don't want for today's video. And before that foundation just settles into my face, I'm just gonna run my sponge. I think foundation is going to be a little bit easy since I don't use too much of product, but the main task is going to be when I use bronzer, highlighter and eyeshadow. Oh my god, how did I forget it? What am I gonna do? I think for today I'm gonna skip applying a lot of eyeshadow shades. I think I'll go with a very simple eye look, because why not? I think that was a good plan because I'm not running out of product. I still have a lot of product on my hand. So I think that was a good decision and I am going pretty well till now. But it's too soon to say that. Let's just see how that goes. I still have a lot of product over here, which makes me feel so happy. So I'm just gonna take a little bit under my eyes on my acne scars, on my lids. I'm quickly gonna prime my lids with the same foundation, and I think I'm gonna bring it down my neck and I'll just scrape all of that foundation. I'm not gonna leave anything for today. All right, so the foundation has been laid down pretty well. I actually purchased in a blush recently, but you know what? I think I'm gonna go with the old school style, that is using a lipstick as a blush, because this blush is not that pigmented and I actually don't want to experiment with my makeup today. So I'm just gonna go with the old school style. I'm using this lipstick and I'm just gonna try to scrape as much product as possible. And that's it, all that we get. I think that's enough for a blush. I'm just gonna use my fingers because, as I said, that sponges usually tend to soak up all the product. So I'm just gonna use my fingers. Okay, for the last time, I'm gonna take my damp sponge and just blend it out a little bit more. And yeah, that's it, blush is done. So I'm gonna set my face. I'm using Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder. It is in the shade 15 Light. What I'm gonna do is, I'll take out some of that powder on the cap. I don't think I'll have a lot of trouble in this because I usually don't use a lot of powder on my face. So I think I'm gonna get along with it, but firstly I'm just gonna make sure that I do not have any creases under my eyes. I usually don't use my damp sponges for my powder, but today I'm gonna do that. So there goes my damp sponge into that powder, and that's it. I cannot take it out. Alright, that's a lot of product. I usually don't use that much of powder on my face, but I want to put it back over there, but I also don't want to, because if I put it over there and if I need it afterwards, I won't be able to take it for the second time. So I'm just gonna do with this and start setting my face. That's a lot of powder, to be honest. A little bit over here, little bit over here, little bit here. And whatever is left on the sponge, I'm just gonna take it down my neck because we are Asians and we don't usually waste our products. So I've set my face. I'm gonna put that powder back in the container and just close it. There you go. I'm not gonna use any of this powder. All right. Next, let's move on to nightmare number one, that is bronzer. Now the thing is, I usually tend to do this and this, this and this, this and this, this and this, and it goes on and on. So today it's gonna be a task because I only have one dip to take as much as bronzer as possible and just go along with it and just not take it for the second time. So there goes a clean brush in the bronzer. There it goes. I'm gonna be a little bit, alright, it has a lot of product in it, as you can see, and I don't know, it's looking patchy. Alright, so I'm just gonna put it back. I'm not gonna use it. Let's just do it a little bit over here, a little bit over here, a little bit over here, around the perimeters, and yeah. All right, bronzer has been done. Now the only face product that is left, it is nightmare number two, that is highlighter. So I think I'm gonna use my fingers first, because fingers usually tends to pick up a lot of product, and I usually go 1,000 times into my highlighter to highlight my whole face. So today we are not getting that chance, so I'm just gonna use my fingers, and there it goes. It's so buttery. That's all what we get. And I promise this is the last time I'm using my damp sponge. I'm just gonna blend the highlighter even more. All right, so highlighting has been done. Now comes Nightmare number 3, which I do not really want to proceed with, but I have to. That is the eyeshadow. I know you have been sitting here for the eyeshadow part. So let's just begin. I'm gonna use this pink shade over here. And there it goes. I hope you can see that. That's a lot of product. Alright, I think that's all what we get. Yeah. What? I'm already running out of product. And I'm just gonna blend it out. I'm also gonna take it on my lower lash line. Do we have anything? Hello, pigment, show up. I'm gonna take a little bit more of a darker shade and I'm gonna use that same brush. I keep forgetting that I can't pick it up. And that's a lot. I'm just gonna stamp it over here. A little bit over here. You know what, I think only thing that can save this eyeshadow look is using some glitter. So I'm just gonna use some liquid eyeshadow. This is from Swiss Beauty. I'm just gonna swirl it as much as can. There comes the product. That's all what we get, guys. And I'm gonna save it for later. I'm just gonna tap it with my fingers and just blend it out a little bit more. I think I'm gonna use this shade. And there goes my brush. I was just about to tap off the excess, but I'm not gonna do that. Now we move on to the eyeliner. I'm gonna be using the good old cheap and best Lakme Insta liner. You know why did I choose this one? That's because this applicator picks up a lot of product, which is like more than enough, I would say, because I'm gonna be using like a strategy to apply my liner. I'm not gonna use this applicator. I'm gonna use like a liner brush. I'm gonna take that product from here and then apply my liner. I know that's a smart decision, but that's how we play, honey. Liner has been done. Here goes the applicator inside that. So I'm just gonna let that liner dry down a little bit and then we're gonna move on to curling our lashes. But till then, we can actually apply our lipstick. I think I'm gonna use this one, since the applicator picks up a lot of product into it. So I'm just gonna, there you go. You see how much product the applicator picks up? I'm gonna mix up a little bit of this lipstick as well, because it's looking too much of pink. My liner has been dried up as well, so I'm just gonna curl up my lashes. And that's all what we get. I think it's more than enough. So here goes the applicator. And that's it. I have completed the challenge. Let me know in the comment section below how I did with the challenge. I personally think I have done a pretty good job. Also, one thing, if you have any more makeup challenge ideas, just let me know in the comment section below. I would love to do that. So that was it for today's video. I hope you liked the video and you did enjoy watching me struggle throughout the video. And if you did, then you know what to do: like, share, subscribe, and also hit the bell icon to get notified every time I upload a video. Also, one thing, don't forget to check the description box. There I will be including all the descriptions of the product and also my social media links if you might wanna be friends with me. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.